The Philippine Senate resumes its probe into the signature campaign for a People's Initiative for Charter Change. This time, the Senate Committee on Electoral Reforms, led by Senator Aimee Marcos, held the hearing in Davao City. The probe seeks to uncover alleged corruption and coercion to secure the signatures.
Ang signature gathering dito sa Davao, katulad sa buong kapulungan, wala naman sanang problema kung tama ang paglikom ng mahalagang mga pirma ng sambayanan. Pero bakit may panlilin lang? Bakit may paayuda na galing din sa kaban ng gobyerno? Bakit hindi masyadong napaliwanag? Ano ang mangyayari kapag natuloy ang amyenda na gusto nilang mangyari? Para sa pagdinig na to, tayo ay pumunta mismo dito sa Davao City dahil nandito mga testigo na kayang humarap sa taong bayan.
The Senate is more than ready to hold accountable all those who have done these evil deeds. That is why I ask you, especially today, trust us. Trust your Senate. Trust us enough to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth. In doing so, you shall also be doing your duty in safeguarding, protecting the very soul of our nation.
More pushback on former President Rodrigo Duterte's call for a secession of Mindanao Island. The latest to reject his idea Friday is his erstwhile military chief, Carlito Galvez Jr., now the government's peace advisor. Galvez, in a statement, urged Filipinos to shun any movements to destabilize the country. He also called the deal as against the letter and spirit of the 1987 Constitution. Danao del Sur Congressman Zia Adion says Duterte's call has no justification. But former House Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez insists on the proposal. He says Mindanao has always lagged in terms of share of government resources.
Huli kami palagi sa priority. Kung hindi huli, nakakalimutan. Kaya pagkaganyan, ano pang aasahan namin sa gobyerno? So we have to find a way kung saan ay yung namang mga concerns ng tao dito ma-address ng gobyerno.
Some good news for shareholders of Facebook's parent firm Meta. The company issued Thursday's first ever dividend as it reported a $40 billion revenue in the final quarter of 2023. The tech giant outplaced its dividend at 50 cents per share to be paid out on March the 26th. Not only that, it also announced a $50 billion share buyback program. Meta shares up since by 14% after the bell. News of its earnings and dividend also raised to over $140 billion, the company's market valuation. All these as Facebook marks its 20th founding anniversary on February 4. The number of job cut announcements in the U.S. reached its highest level in nearly a year in January, 82,307 to be exact. In December, there were only about 34,800 such announcements. According to a report by outplacement firm Challenger, Gray and Christmas, which helps companies with the offboarding process for employees, month on month, the growth in job cut announcements was over 130%. But on a yearly basis, January's figure was actually lower by 20%. The study also found that the financial and technology sectors announced the most job cuts in the first month of 2024. Let's check on the financial markets close to home. Most Asian markets rising thanks to a positive lead from Wall Street overnight. All three major U.S. stock indices ended Thursday's trade in the green, with the Dow Jones setting a fresh record close for the blue chip index. Also lifting sentiment, a late bounce in U.S. tech on Friday as quarterly results from Meta and Amazon beat expectations. Investors are also digesting central bank policy decisions from the U.S., the U.K. and Sweden, all of which left the rates steady this week. Traders are now expecting the Fed to ease monetary policy around the mid-year mark as it signaled its first policy meeting for 2024 that cuts won't come as early as March. Taking a look now at the board, South Korea's KOSPI index leading Friday's gains after Seoul's consumer inflation slowed to a six-month low in January. Consumer price index stood 2.8% higher in January, lower than December's 3.2%. In the land down under, the ASX 200 closed higher as investors assess Australia's latest producer price index. Canberra's fourth quarter producer price index rose at a faster pace of 4.1% year on year. That's higher than the third quarter's 3.8%. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They are pointing to a mixed open despite positive cues from the US and Asia. The German DAX looks set to extend its losing streak to a third straight session following a data-heavy day yesterday, which indicated the inflation was easing in the Eurozone, but there are underlying price pressures remaining. Stateside now, futures are projecting another rally for Wall Street. All eyes are on the January jobs report.
Some corporate stories as the trading week comes to a close. Bank of the Philippine Islands sees a record full-year net income in 2023. The figure stood at 51.7 billion pesos, higher by over 30% from last year's 39.6 billion. BPI's fourth quarter net income was also up nearly half of a percent to 13.1 billion pesos. Total revenue is also higher at 138.3 billion pesos. The Ayala-led bank points to record revenues as well as lower provisions for the stellar earnings, which it says offset higher operating expenses. Still on earnings, Land Bank also reached a record high profit last year. The net income of the state-run institution hit 40.3 billion pesos in 2023. This was on the back of strong revenues from loans and investments, among others. Land Bank's assets also up to 3.3 trillion pesos. And finally, Basic Energy Corporation inks a deal with Japanese firm Renova to develop a wind project in Batangas Province. The agreement was signed Thursday after Basic Energy secured board approval for the undertaking. The wind energy project in Mabini Town has a potential capacity of 50 megawatts. It is expected to begin operations and deliver power to the grid by 2027.